Hi, my name is Paul Yuknovich. I'm one of the lead program managers on the Visual Studio Cloud Platform Tools team. Today, we'll see the tools that we use to build and diagnose Windows Azure applications. We'll get an overview of the different kinds of compute containers that we can program against, and then we'll see how we can create the resources we need to build that application and to go ahead and diagnose it in real time. Let's get started working with Windows Azure and building Azure applications. I will load Visual Studio 2013. And we have a number of new entry points in Visual Studio once you've installed the Azure SDK that make it really easy, easier than ever, to get connected to Windows Azure. You can look in the Tools menu. You can see there's Connect to Windows Azure next to Connect to Servers and SharePoint. You can also open Server Explorer, which is a great place to explore Windows Azure. And here we have the right-click option to connect to Windows Azure. Now all I have to do is sign in using my Microsoft account or my organizational account. Here I'll use my Microsoft account that's linked to my MSDN subscription. And once I've signed in, Visual Studio is completely connected to all of the services and all of the resources contained in my subscriptions. If I want to get further insight into what the connection looks like, I can right-click on the Windows Azure node, click Manage Subscriptions, and I can see the identity that I'm signed into and what level of subscription that I have. And this actually supports one or more subscriptions for sign-in. Also, for those of you who've done Windows Azure development in the past, we might be used to using management certificates in published settings. That's also still supported in Visual Studio, and I can go ahead and import them, or I can create new certificates here. What we'll do first is we'll create a new project. And a lot of times what we want to do is we want to build web applications that use data and that use other services. I can start there on the web node, and I can build web applications just as I normally would on-premise. And keep in mind that later on, as a publishing option, we'll be able to publish to Windows Azure. Also, we have other options, just to be aware of. If you want to start with a multi-layered cloud service application for something at internet scale, I could start with a Windows Azure cloud service. We even have the ability to create rich Windows Store apps that use Windows Azure mobile services as a back end. So you have a number of options here. Let's start with web. We'll create an ASP.NET web application. Here we have a new feature that we call OneASP.NET, where you can see all the different options and kinds of ASP.NET technologies we can use. I'll start with MVC, but just know that I can layer in other kinds of references and technologies. Let's say I want to add a web API. I can add that to my existing project. I also have a number of authentication options, which helps when I want to use my organizational accounts or if I want to use some internet-based sign-in. We'll hit OK. And now Visual Studio is creating that application that I can use either on-premise or in Windows Azure. One thing that's new is we're seeing a newer starting page for your application that helps you understand the most common tasks and helps you understand a little bit more about the default application pattern that we create for you. You can always hit F5 or click the Start button, and that will launch the application. So you can always really start in that running state. In this case, when we hit F5, we're running on the local machine. Once we've built out the application, the first features that we'd like to see, we can go ahead and publish. And we think of publish as the next step, even for a dev and test environment, to make sure that your application will work in the real environment. One feature that's all new is we can import publish settings directly from Windows Azure, which makes it really easy to dev and test and publish directly into Windows Azure. This publishing feature is also aware of the sign-in. So you can see I'm signed in with my Microsoft account and my MSDN subscription. I could also use a different identity here. And simply, we can see all of the targetable Windows Azure websites. And if I don't see the application target that I'd like, I can go ahead and create a new Windows Azure website. We'll hit OK. And Visual Studio downloads all the settings that I need to publish. And we can follow the wizard. One thing I like to do is when I'm doing a clean developer test install, I like to make sure that all the additional files are cleaned up and match this deployment. We could preview, and then we'll publish. And just a few moments later, exactly the same application we saw locally is now running in the cloud in Windows Azure. And I have a number of tools inside of Visual Studio, inside of Server Explorer, that make it easy to do additional dev and test tasks. For example, I can see the websites and the status, including the one that I just deployed. I can right-click. I can do things like view the settings. And this gives me the most common developer settings that I have for the site, and it allows me to work inside of Visual Studio without having to leave and go to the management portal. If I want to do diagnostics tasks, I have a number of options that are really interesting here. For example, I can view the streaming logs and see the exact trace output coming from my application. I could even use the remote debugging preview, and I can attach a remote debugger just for my own instance, and I can hit breakpoints live in Windows Azure. So just a number of tools that help you build and diagnose the application. Now, moving from the simple example of a website, we can also transition into the multi-tiered, multi-layered applications and use the cloud service container in Windows Azure. If I want to use that, I can right-click on any web project and get started with cloud services by saying convert and convert to Windows Azure cloud service project. What this will do, this will create the cloud service project, which helps me with packaging and deployment and helps me model the multi-tiered application in the multi-VM application that I'd like to run in Windows Azure. So I can see I got this new project. It's set as the startup project. And my front-end web application now is a role for my cloud service, meaning it's one of the tiers, logically, or it's one of the VMs that I'll have. And I can add additional tiers or additional roles quite easily. So I can say add new worker role. We'll take the defaults. And now very quickly, I'm building up an application that has a front-end tier and that has one or more back-end tiers to do the heavy lifting and to do the processing. And I can always double-click on any of the roles, and I can modify the application in the application configuration. So for example, I can see how many instances or number of VMs that will be allocated to scale this, this tier. I could also add settings and configuration. So for example, I'd like to hook up my front end tier to my storage account. So we'll create a connection string. And Visual Studio makes it really easy to look into my subscription and find all of the storage accounts that I can use. Here's the one I want in West US. All right. And now what I'd like to do is I'd like to start building this application to, in my front end, be able to queue up work having to do with images. And basically any time that an image is uploaded, I'd like to upload that image and then create a queue message. And in my back-end worker roles, what I'd like to do is listen for those queue messages. And when they come in, I'd like to do additional tasks like compression, like caching that image in multiple data centers, etc. So this gives you the idea of the kinds of cloud scale things that we'll try to do. So let's go back into our web application and let's add some very simple code that gets us started with the queue processing. So we'll go into our controller. And just for the sake of hello world, we'll take an existing controller action, like the about action. And we'll paste in some starter code. And you can see here that using the Cloud Configuration Manager object in the Windows Azure namespace, we can get that setting that we just defined in the tool. And this works both in ASP.NET web applications and also in cloud services, even in VM kind of code. Then what we can do is we can build up a cloud storage account and a queue client to work with our queue storage. We will get a reference to the images queue, and if we're not sure if we have that queue already, we can always go into Server Explorer. We can look into all of our storage accounts. We can see that this matching images queue is there. Even if I didn't have one, the tools help me create what I need just to get going with development. All right. And then we get into the interesting code where we'll create a queue message. We'll do a hello world style message here. We'll add the message and we'll have some basic error handling such that when I do the live tracing and I do the diagnostics, I'm tracing my errors directly to that listener, and the tools can help you pick up and do some troubleshooting. So let's go ahead and run this very simple multi-tiered app that does queuing. Now in this case, we're used to seeing messages like this where we need to run cloud service emulators as an administrator. We have a really cool new feature where we have an express version of the emulator and it no longer needs to run as administrator. So if I right-click on my cloud project and I go to the properties, click on web, just like I can pick IS Express, I can now pick the emulator express. And again, this will be lighter weight, and it allows us to run as a normal user. So I can hit F5 again. And we'll deploy right into this local emulator. All right, and what we want to do, we want to trigger the code that will queue a message. So let's click on the About button, which will hit the queue controller. And let's do a little basic diagnostics and analysis. So what we'll do is we'll go to the Server Explorer, we'll go to this queue that we queued a message into. I'll double click it, and I can see that this message has been queued. So the tools help me instrument the different tiers of my application and help me see the data as it's flowing. And this is really, really helpful for troubleshooting. Also, what I could do, I can force actions, like I can dequeue the message myself, or I could enter my own queue message just for testing purposes. You can really see how Visual Studio works with you to build, get started with, and troubleshoot an application using these interactive tools. So that was a quick tour through web development, scaling to internet cloud development. One other area I mentioned is we can now do mobile development in conjunction with Windows Azure. So let's create a new application. Let's go to Windows Store. We'll pick a grid app. And here I'm seeing the getting started pattern for a grid application that will run in the Windows Store. And what I can do to get started, I can add a connected service reference. And this is a rich manager that's like Ad Reference, but it can see into my subscriptions. And I can, since I've signed in and since I've imported my subscription, I can see a mobile service backend that I've created inside of Windows Azure. And if I didn't have this backend, we'd give you the tools to easily type in a few parameters, get a free database, and go ahead and create that mobile service. And all I need to do is hit OK. And as a part of the connection, what we'll do is we'll add the connection information, like the app name and key. We give you a scaffold of code, and now we have what we need to get connected to the mobile service. Definitely check out the additional content that shows you the deep dive on working with mobile services and Windows Store apps. So with that said, we saw a number of things from getting started with the tools to building and troubleshooting applications. We even created a mobile application. I'd like to conclude on showing some additional options you should check out that make it easier to integrate with the lifecycle tools that we have in Visual Studio. I'll call out in the Windows Azure portal. You can go to a cloud service or a website. You can open it in the dashboard. And we have options like setting up deployment from source control. So using this kind of feature, we have integration between our team services and our Git services that make continuous integration and continuous delivery very easy. All right, so to summarize, we saw how easy it is to work with and build applications that use Windows Azure and Visual Studio 2013. Thank you very much for watching this session. We look forward to you getting these tools and checking it out. Let us know what you think.